YouTube, what to do, everybody? Back with another video. I know yesterday, on January 13th, we had an update, and the DMR zone just got updated, right? The Warzone update. Nerfed the DMR a little bit. I'm still seeing that it's pretty overpowered, and I played it a little bit and got killed by it. Still pretty quick. But anyway, we have some updates on that. So I think that Warzone is more playable now. I haven't touched it in a while, so I'm excited to jump in that and see what that is like. And today they just dropped the Reloaded update. So Season 1 Reloaded, a little bit of it, and what's to come. So we're going to take a look at this. I'm going to get right to the point. I don't want this video to be very long, so we're going to go ahead and jump right into it. So anyway, man, so this is, like I said, Black Ops Cold War and Warzone Season 1 Reloaded. We got the new Express map, or new for Cold War, remake, right? We have League Play, and we have a lot more. So as you guys can see right here, this is a mid-season update, and this will have more throughout the second half of the season as we continue to go. So the action won't stop there. So on February 4th, prepare to win the chapter of the Dark Aether storyline and zombies return to competitive fan favorite Black Ops map and multiplayer, in addition to fresh bundles rolling out in the beginning of the month to celebrate the holidays of the season, which I think they did best for holidays in the season was back in World War II. I just made a video on that, and they had extremely good camos. I know that game a lot of people did not like, but the camos were wonderful, and they have tons of seasonal events in that game, which is awesome. And they're usually all free, I believe. So, and here's for the Season 1 Reloaded, this map art looks absolutely unbelievable, guys. If you take a look at it, we got the Firebase Z, which is the new zombies map. We have the new cranked zombies mode, which is live now. We have Cold War, obviously the zombies. It's free access week for everybody from January 14th through the 21st. So anybody can play zombies here in Cold War, even if you do not own the game. We have the Wakizashi, I think that's how you pronounce it. We have Xena, the new operator that comes January 21st, as you can see. Then Sanatorium, it's actually live now. I believe that is a new multiplayer map. Then we have Express coming February 4th. And we also have a new Fire Team map as well. So League Play, and this is coming, it says in season. So a lot of people said February 4th, League Play will arrive. I'm not exactly sure about that. So we have some new game modes and some new multiplayer modes down here. So it looks like a pretty good update. So we have the new weaponry. We have the Wakizashi, which is available now. And you get this awesome operator skin that I'm going to be purchasing this bundle and actually making a video on it as well. You may have seen it already, and it may be after this. I haven't decided yet. So it looks like a nice little weapon right here, and nice bundle. That outfit will be awesome to run in some Warzone and in some multiplayer. So I will be getting that. And then we have the, that will be a blueprint for the weapon. So with that operator, you get a bundle blueprint, or you get a blueprint in the bundle for the Wakizashi sword. And then we move on to the Xena. She joins the fight on January 21st. Excuse me. This is a new operator, and her name is Xena. I'm sure there'll be a new skin, new weapon bundles, all that good stuff. Probably a tracer pack, maybe. I wouldn't be surprised if there's a tracer pack in this. So just be ready for that. And I will be getting that if it is a tracer pack, 100%. Okay. And we have new two multiplayer maps. We have Sanatorium, which is live now. I've heard this looks amazing, and it kind of has that Blackout vibe to it. So this will be very interesting. So 10 squads of four will head up to the Earl Plains to fight over objectives and vehicles on land, sea, and air. So what game mode is that? Other than Warzone, that is Fireteam Dirty Bomb. So I know a lot of people don't like Fireteam Dirty Bomb too much, but this map, I guess, looks really, really good. If you're interested in Blackout, you may be interested in this. So, and we have that, and then we have Express coming, which is 6v6. A lot of us have played that back in the day, bring back some nostalgia. All these remade maps are coming back out. So I'm hoping, Firing Range, Summit, Slums, I want those to come back. I want good maps to play. I don't think those would get old. It would be nice to have something fun that's new, or a new good map, but they struggle with that, it seems like. And we have so Express arrives, which is February 4th, and it's one of the fan favorites. You guys know that. You guys know what that is like. So multiplayer modes, which I'm actually really excited to try this game mode. We have Dropkick. Okay, I'll read a little bit of this. The frantic game of Nuclear Hot Potato features two teams, each vying for control of an extremely important briefcase. The round begins with each team racing to the location of a nuclear briefcase and attempting to pick it up. Anyone grabbing the briefcase is automatically equipped with a powerful pistol, but it's ideally up to the rest of the team to keep the briefcase carrier safe. The team with the case gains access to launch codes as well as an ever-increasing score for their team. So I kind of heard from what I was watching earlier, it's kind of like a hard point. By holding the objective, you get more points, and it's kind of like a search and destroy because you got to search for the person with the briefcase. So those two mix, I don't know, we'll have to see. It sounds kind of fun to me. Then we have the Snipers Only Mosh Pit, which is coming in season, and this is 6v6 Snipers Only. So if you're a sniper, get those clips, baby. I'm not a sniper, but I did enjoy this. I remember playing Snipers Only in Black Ops 4, and I actually had a lot of fun with that game mode. Even though I'm not a very good sniper, I did have a lot of fun, and I was able to get some clips because I got better at it as I continued to do it. And then we have Endurance Mode, which is in season, and Endurance, it's 10 squads of 4 will drop into Alpine, Rookit, and Sanatorium, which is a fire team 30 bomb maps, and you'll collect uranium, all that good stuff. The score limit will be doubled from 500 to 1,000 in Endurance Mode, making this perfect for completing MP challenges, jumping with your squad, and experience the game's most elaborate maps in an entirely new way. So what this says to me, they're bringing back Endurance for fire team 30 bomb. You guys know what's coming. Remember Chaos Control, remember Chaos Hardpoint, we had Endurance Hardpoint, Endurance Domination, the Endurance Mosh Pit. I think that's going to be coming, and that will be absolutely insane on this game. Like, 300, 500 kill games. Like, just like Black Ops 4, I think it could be just like this. I can't wait for that. I'm excited. I'm sure they will be adding that in the near future if Endurance is coming to Fireteam. So a lot of people love Endurance Mode. We have 3v3 face-off, and we've already seen that. Just the same thing, it's 3v3. You got Domination, TDM, Kill Confirm on the same maps right here. We have the Zombies update. This is the big part right here. So in February, the Dark Aether storyline continues with a new Cold War Zombies map. Sooner than you have expected, but before that arrives, expect to fight your life in Crank and the new Onslaught for PlayStation owners only, I know. And welcome in the new Zombies community during Zombies Free Access Week. So you can play it during the Free Access Week, which starts today until the 21st. And then you have a new mode, which is Cranked, which is live now. I haven't even jumped into that. There's a timer, and it looks really fun. Cranked, it sounds like a frantic game mode. We're going crazy, killing as many zombies as possible. I haven't tried it yet. I'm interested, and I may do that. And the new Onslaught map, it's Raid, which is live now. Then Express, February 4th. So those will be, basically you just go to a certain spot in the Zombies map if you haven't played it, and you kill as many zombies as you can until you collect a certain amount of, like, orbs, or kill as many zombies as possible. And then once you get the kill counter all the way up, then you switch to a new spot, and it gets harder. New bosses come every so round. So it's pretty fun, actually, but it's only two player, and it is only for PlayStation users. So Free Access Week, like I said, new Zombies map, Firebase Z, February 4th, with the site of the project in station destroyed after investigating the Dark Aether anomaly. In Poland, the Requiem response team led by Gregory Weaver now turns in attention to the latest outbreak site, codenamed Firebase Z. So that sounds fun. Like, Firebase Z, that just fits perfect Zombies type of game mode. Okay, and that's basically it. As we move on, the next chapter of Black Ops Cold War begins on February 4th as Season 1 continues. Watch for more intel in Treyarch and their 115-day celebration blog today and tomorrow. And then we have all the blogs, and then we have all the bundles that will be coming to the game. So that is basically it for this. Yeah, man, it looks a pretty good update. This is just only part of it. So we have a lot more coming here in the near future, along with League Play. So I'm very excited how League Play is going to come out, and I wonder if skill-based matchmaking is gone. No, I don't think so. But League Play will be out. That will be fun to watch some competitive Call of Duty, that people that do play League Play a little bit. So yeah, man, that's all I have for you today. I'm going to cut it right there. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. Smash that like. Don't even hit that subscribe button. Just smash the like. That's what we're shooting for. Hit the like button. I would greatly appreciate it. I will catch y'all in the next one. Peace.